Problem is to write a Python program to read a file line by line into a list. Hello everyone, a very warm welcome to WsCube Tech. My name is Ayushi Jain. In this video, we will learn how to write a program that will allow us to read a file. That means if we have a file, if we have a .txt file and we have some lines written in it, and we want to read those lines in a format of a list, how it can be done using Python, we'll be looking at that in this video. Also, this can be achieved by two methods. Our first method is by using the readLines method, and the second method over here would be the loop and the list comprehension. So we'll be looking at both of them one by one. First of all, talking about the readLines method, let's have a look on how it can be done. So solution one is using read lines. For reading the lines, first of all, I'll be opening the file in the reading mode. So f is equals to open. If to open a file, we write f is equals to open. We open the parentheses and over here we pass the name of the file inside double quotation. Now what is the name of the file? So I have already created a file which is called as file.txt. Inside this I have written, hello everyone, this is my demo file. I hope you all like it. So the name of my file is file.txt, and remember one thing, that it should be, this file should be there in the same location where your Python codes are there. That means the path of this file and the path of this code should be same. If it is not same, in that case you need to specify the path here. Okay, so open file.txt, comma, in which mode we are going to open it? We are going to open it in the reading mode. Once we have opened it in the reading mode, now we need to write, I'll be calling a variable called as line. Line is equals to, that means we'll be using this f function here. F dot read lines, open close the parentheses. Let's print what is there inside this line variable. Okay, so you can now see that we have read all the lines which was there inside our file, and they all got printed over here. That hello everyone, a backslash n is representing that whatever is the next line, it is in the next line. That means it's not in the same line over here. It's over here it's showing it in the same line, but actually it is in the next line. Now what we need to do, we need to remove this backslash and n. I'll be using the list comprehension method. For that I'll be writing a variable called as, so new lines is equals to, because it's a list, I'll be writing x dot strip. Now strip method will allow us to remove blank spaces. What are the blank spaces? This backslash n. Backslash n over here means that you are going to the next line. Now next line over here means that after your first line, we have all the blank spaces over here and those need to be stripped. So x dot strip for x in line. Once we are done with this, I'll be printing the new lines as well, and we'll see the comparison between both of them. Then what is the comparison between the line and the new lines? So as soon as I run it, now you will notice that I have received two outputs. The first output is with our backslash n, and the second output over here is with the strip method. That using the strip method, we have removed the blank spaces. That means the backslash n has been removed and all the lines are coming directly in the format of a list. So I hope guys that the first method over here is clear, that all we need to do is we need to open the file in the reading mode, read the lines. Once you read the line, it will give you the output in the format of a list, that all the lines which are there inside the file, they are written inside the list. And once we have received those lines, what we need to do is we need to remove those blank spaces. To remove the blank spaces, we will be using the strip method and we will be using the list comprehension. Now this was our method number one, that means solution number one to do this program. We have another solution over here in which we will be using the loops and the list comprehension. Now to read the lines over here, we will be using the loop. Let's have a look on how it can be done. So again, for our solution number two, we need to first open the file and read it. To open the file, we'll be writing f is equals to open. Which file we need to open? File.txt we need to open. So file.txt. And in which mode we will be opening it? In the reading mode. Once we have opened the file in the reading mode, now what I need to do is I need to create a variable called as line. Inside this I'll be passing a list, and list, why I'm using a list? Because I need to obtain these lines in a format of a list. So I'll be writing line for line in f. Okay, this is a list comprehension method. If you want, you can put this one as lines. Okay, because we'll be obtaining the multiple lines. Let's print and see what we will obtain inside the lines. As soon as I run it, I'll get the output in this way, that I'll be obtaining, hello everyone, this is my demo file. Again, the backslashes and n's are there because of the next line, that the text is in the next line. That means if you have a text and this space over here after this is indicating that it is in the next line. Okay, So backslash over here is representing that it is in the next line. To remove it, again we will be using the same method that we used on the top. That means we'll be creating a variable called as new lines is equals to, again we'll be using the square brackets, x dot strip, open close the parentheses, for x in lines. Once we're done with this, we'll be printing the new lines. Let's run and see what output we'll get. So we will be getting this output that our new list will have no more backslash ends. So I hope guys the second method over here is also clear, that first of all we need to again open the file in the reading mode, read the lines in the format of a list. That means we'll be using a for loop and we'll be writing line for line in f. That means all the data will come over here in the format of the list which is there inside the file. Once we print it, we get the output like this, which will contain backslash and n. To remove the blank spaces, what we'll be doing, we'll be using x.strip method. Inside x.strip, we will not be passing anything because the default value is backspaces. That means if you want to remove the blank spaces, all you need to write is x.strip, open close the parentheses. Open close parentheses over here shows that the default value is blank spaces. So I hope guys that both the methods are clear to you and you have no doubts in the questions. The link of this code is present in our description, and for more such interesting videos, stay connected guys. Thank you.